Where the child is persistently breathing through an open mouth, this can affect their sleep, their academic performance, their brain development, their craniofacial development. It's very important for growing children to breathe in and out through the nose with the correct tongue resting posture with their lips together. In addition, a child who is persistently mouth breathing, their tongue is not able to rest in the roof of the mouth, and as a result, their tongue is midway or on the floor of the mouth. We have to think of the tongue as scaffolding for the jaws. So with the mouth closed, the tongue should be rested against the palate, against the roof of the mouth. And as the tongue is resting against the roof of the mouth, it helps to ensure adequate craniofacial development. In short, it's the pressure exerted by the tongue as it rests in the roof of the mouth which directs the growth of the jaws. And ideally, the growing child develops a wide maxilla, so their top jaw is wide, which in turn will ensure that there's plenty of room for their teeth. But more importantly, when the mouth is closed and the tongue is resting in the roof of the mouth, it helps to ensure the forward growth of the jaws, and this assists with development of the airway. When I was a child and teenager, and also into my early 20s, I persistently mouth-breathed. During that time, it was never mentioned to me whether I should be breathing through my nose or through my mouth. I struggled in school, I struggled with sleep, I was highly strung, and at 14 years of age, I left school never to go back, out of a total sense of frustration, because in school, I didn't have the capacity to hold my attention on what the teacher is saying. There are many children who are persistently mouth breathing, and this common and negative habit is often overlooked. These kids are not going to reach their full potential. And what's more, the issues created during the formative years can often carry all the way through that child's life. So from a craniofacial point of view, my nose is crooked because my maxilla, my top jaw, has not came forward enough. I had overcrowding of teeth. My mandible is set back. I have a double chin. I've got a compromised airway. So anatomically, my face, my airway, has not developed the way it should do. Mouth breathing contributed to that. If you were looking for instruction and exercises to show your child how to switch from mouth to nasal breathing, download Buteyko Clinic app. It's available on Android and also from iTunes. There's a section for children, and in this you will find every breathing exercise as it applies to children. Exercises to help if the child is feeling stressed or anxious. Exercises to help decongest the child's nose. Exercises to breathe through the nose during physical movements such as jogging and running. Exercises to improve their breathing from a biochemical point of view and a biomechanical point of view. And how to help ensure nasal breathing during sleep. If you would like to know more about the science of how mouth breathing affects childhood development, airway development, brain development, I suggest that you read my book called The Breathing Cure. The book is available from our website, and it's also available from amazon.com.co.uk and is published in a number of languages. It's very easy to work with children, and all too often, mouth breathing has been ignored. It shouldn't be.